is precious something, exorbitant rates, like 500 rupees a liter. That's where. So people, this is the way they transported the material, you know. The stack of firewood on a bicycle. It's so telling. Yeah, next. This is the pain, you know. At the center there are two old ladies who are mentally disturbed. There is a kid over there who is not even 1.5 years, who got injured because of a piece of a bomb that hit him, and he saved it somehow. Here is the man who has lost his leg. There is a woman almost into 80s, no place to, nobody to support. It's like that. Unless and until we decide to support that community, well, everybody is there, and there are small babies, young babies, might be 6 months, might be 8 months, might be. And there was a baby which was just 15 days. And the person in charge of that orphanage tells me, look, this baby was handed over to us a fortnight back by a lady who walked into us, just handed over. And because her husband, who is in IDP, internally displaced camps, IDP camp, will be released in a month, she handed this baby over because of the Sri Lankan army having, you know, used that lady otherwise. That was disturbing. And the baby, because she cannot take back this baby to her village, she handed it over to the ashram. Anyway. So that's how it's all over there. The next. So 1 year and 6 months I visited after that. Situation still grim and tense. Need special permission to travel. We cannot take pictures. Where to watch? If somebody is some military man. Earlier we had reconstructed post-tsunami in Sri Lanka, 2 villages, 100 houses in the east of Sri Lanka, Batticaloa district. And now here are we serving in the northeast. That's how we are working. You're all invited to help those helpless people in the northeast of Sri Lanka. Please help them. And not only them, wherever there is pain, we must come together, join hands, and serve the humanity to make this world a better place. Thank you very much for listening to me. Thank you.